Welcome to the Fit Small Business QuickBooks Online training course. In this lesson, we're going to cover how to write and print checks. To follow along with me, log into your QuickBooks Online account now or click the link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. You can also click this link to access our full QuickBooks Online course and other helpful resources. Let's get started. There are a few benefits to creating checks in QuickBooks Online that manually writing checks does not offer you. By creating the check in QuickBooks, you do not have to manually enter the check later when it is time to reconcile your checking account with the bank statement. Second, your QuickBooks file is always up to date with the most recent expenses that you have paid. And finally, you can print your checks directly from QuickBooks so that you don't have to manually write them. In general, you should write a check in QuickBooks to pay for goods and services for which payment is due immediately. For example, for any supplier who you have not established credit terms with, payment will most likely be due upon receipt. Similarly, if you owe taxes and need to send a check along with your tax return, then you would want to make that payment right away. For the purposes of this video, we will use a fictitious company called Paul's Plumbing. As you view this video, think about how the information might differ for your business. After you log into your account, to begin, let's go ahead and click on the plus sign and then go ahead and click on check right below the vendor column. The write checks window will display on your screen. There are 11 fields that need to be completed. The first field is the payee field. You want to select the vendor that you are paying from the drop-down menu. If you have not set up the supplier in QuickBooks yet, then you can click on the drop-down arrow and scroll up to the Add New option. Click this link to watch our Setting Up Vendors lesson. We walk you through step-by-step on how to set up your vendors in QuickBooks. The next field is the bank account field. Go ahead and select the bank account that you want to write the check from. Mailing address. This information will automatically populate from the vendor's profile. If you have not set up the supplier yet, then this field will be blank. You can enter the address directly in this field, but it will not update the vendor profile. The payment date should be the date that you plan to print the check. Account. Select the account that you track this type of expense in. If you have not set up an account to track the expense, then you can click the drop-down arrow and scroll up to Add New. Click this link to watch our video tutorial on setting up the chart of accounts. In this lesson, we walk you through step-by-step on how to set up your expense and income accounts in QuickBooks. The description field will automatically populate with the description that you set up the account with. You can also customize this field by typing directly into it. However, the information that you type here in the description field will not update the description in the chart of accounts. If needed, you will have to go into the chart of accounts to update the description with the change. Go ahead and enter the amount of the payment in the next field. Check number field. If you are going to print the check now, go ahead and enter the next available check number in the check number field. If you are not going to print the check now, put a check mark in the checkbox below that to mark the check to be printed at a later date. If you are ready to print the check and you indicated a check number above, you want to go ahead and click this button, Print Checks, at the bottom of the screen here to proceed to print the check. If this is your first time printing checks in QuickBooks, click here for step-by-step instructions on where to buy checks and how to print checks in QuickBooks Online. Once you have completed all of the fields, we are ready to save and close. After you have finished writing the check, you want to go ahead and locate the check within QuickBooks and review it. So let's go ahead and navigate to the check register. From the left-hand menu bar, click on Transactions and Banking. Go ahead and click on Go to Register on the far right. And the check that we created for nuts and bolts is located at the very top. You want to go ahead and review the information here. Notice that the balance in the check register has been reduced by this check, even though we have not printed the check yet. It still has a status of to print. To gain a better understanding of the impact checks have on your financial statements and what's happening behind the scenes in QuickBooks, click this link to access the step-by-step instructions for this lesson. That wraps up the lesson on how to write and print checks in QuickBooks Online. To access our full QuickBooks Online course or any of the other lessons in this series, click this link. You can also find a link below this video for a free 30-day trial of QuickBooks Online. If you have feedback about this course or if you have any questions, please leave a comment below. Also, don't forget to subscribe.